Hello and welcome to this video series on the Power BI Adoption Framework, which is about empowering every decision maker. I'm Manu.
And I'm Paul.
In this video, we'll talk about user identity in Power BI. The first thing to note is that Power BI is a part of Microsoft Cloud offerings and the Power BI service is hosted in Azure. Power BI uses Azure Active Directory for authentication and login. This means that if you already have an Azure Active Directory set up, which you're using for Azure services or Office 365, then you can reuse it. If you're already using SharePoint Online, Exchange Online, or other Office 365 applications, then when you log into Power BI, your user will already be set up. If you do not already have a user, then when you sign into Power BI, we will create a user for you in the Azure Active Directory. Any user can sign up to use Power BI, which will assign a free license to that individual, unless this has been blocked by your IT team. If no one has yet signed up for Power BI, a new tenant will be created on your behalf. If your IT team wants to take over and manage this tenant later, then they can do an admin request takeover to do so. Azure Active Directory is used to secure all of your Microsoft resources with a common set of users and groups. So you will use the same login for Dynamics 365, SharePoint Online, Flow, and other Azure services. The benefit of using Azure Active Directory, or AAD, is that we can use all of its components, including how it is set up. Most organizations already have an identity structure. Some may already be using Azure Active Directory or have managed identities, or just want to sync the password. If you have federated identities, you can use Azure Directory Federation Services or third-party solutions to connect to your Azure Active Directory. The most common scenario we see with our customers is that they already have an on-premises directory or identity management set up, and you can then just set up Azure Active Directory Connect, so you only need to manage a user once. This means that whenever you add a user to your on-premises Active Directory, this user will automatically be created in Azure Active Directory. So the users can then sign into Power BI using the same username and password as they use to log into Windows. Now that we have discussed Azure Active Directory and how a user can log into Power BI, we can establish that we know who is logged into Power BI. I will now explain the steps that Power BI takes to authenticate a user. Firstly, a user needs to sign into app.powerbi.com in a browser. In my case, if I were to log in, I would be logged in from the UK, but the Microsoft tenant is held in the US. When I load app.powerbi.com, I will be directed to Azure Traffic Manager, which will figure out where I am located and return this to the browser. This will redirect me to a web frontend which is running ASP.NET. This web frontend will be located in the nearest Azure data center to my location. So in my case, this would redirect me to UK South. The web frontend will then call the Microsoft login page and prompt me to log in. This will redirect the login to Azure Active Directory. Now the web frontend knows who I am. Next, the web frontend will look in an Azure table storage to see where my tenant is located. This table has an entry to say that Microsoft's tenant is in South Central US. This information will be passed to the browser. And the browser will start to load common content like CSS, JavaScript, images, etc. from Azure Content Delivery Network. These are generic items used by everyone. The last step is when I will be redirected to the backend service. This is where reports and dashboards are rendered using your data. This backend service is running in a single region.
Because we are leveraging Azure Active Directory, we can benefit from a number of features built into it to enhance your security. This means that you can use features such as multi-factor authentication, forcing users to have two-factor auth to be able to log in. You need to have an Office 365 license or have Azure Active Directory Premium to use this. You can have the second factor be a phone call, text, or the Azure Authenticator app. If you have an on-premises identity provider, you can use anything that this IDP supports. Another thing that Azure Active Directory supports is user access controls. This gives admins the ability to enforce PIN requirements on the mobile application when signing in. This is done through Intune and can be controlled for Power BI mobile apps on iOS or Android. You can also stop users from downloading any apps from the standard app store by using a company portal. which means only applications registered in there and via Intune can be used. The last thing you can control with AAD is conditional access. This gives you the ability to have fine-grained control over how users can access the data. You could restrict users so they can only log into Power BI from inside your organization's buildings by controlling which IP address can connect. You could also say that you can only connect from specific devices, maybe only allowing connecting from corporate devices. You could also restrict so only certain users or groups of users are allowed to connect to Power BI. You can also use any combination of these settings as well. So for example, in Microsoft, if I log in over VPN, I do not need to do two-factor authentication. But if I'm not on VPN, I need to authorize my login from the Authenticator mobile app. All of these can allow you to lock down Power BI to meet your organization's specific requirements. The last set of controls you can put in place are to configure the Power BI admin settings. You can disable user signup or disable sharing or exporting for some or all the users. For more information on the different admin controls, please watch part 3 in the series where we look at these settings in more detail. Do you want to add controls for Power BI environment access? As we've discussed, you can block non-corporate tenants, enable two-factor authentication, or disable self-signup for Power BI. Please see the description below for links with more information and how to implement these changes. As with all options decided in this workshop, we recommend that you document the decision and make everyone aware. If you're looking for guidance on how to implement Azure Active Directory with Power BI, or want to see what solutions our partners can create for you, then please check out the marketplace. The link is in the description below. We've included a link to the slides used in this presentation in the description below. Thanks for listening, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment. See you in the next one.